Hi, my name is Judy Elmore, and I'm a freelance editor with Black Wolf Editorial Services. Over the course of a variety of different videos, I've been showing you how to use Scrivener and use it to your full advantage as a writer. Today, I'm going to show you a feature about the research folder. One of the things I love about Scrivener is the fact that you can actually import into Scrivener any and all web links and other information like images or research notes to help you while you're writing your manuscript. So it is all at your fingertips and you're not having to hunt through your computer or your bookmark notes for that one special bit of information that you might need. So this is what we do. If we're going to look at web pages, I'm going to right hand click and I'm going to add a file from a web page. So I'm going to check this option here. And I had a little bit of a play before. I went looking on the internet for files about Jules Verne. Of course, for those of you who have been watching our videos from the beginning, you'll know that we've been playing with Jules Verne and the journey to the interior of the earth. So if we look at the pages that I've selected, I found one on Wikipedia, and of course I found another one over on online literature, and then I found this one as well, which was quite a detailed description of his life. So I'm going to show you what we do. We're going to select that URL and we're going to copy it, Control C for those of you who are on Windows, and then I'm going to paste it into this address here. Now you can give it a special title if you wish. I'm not going to. I'm just going to let the system choose what it wants to do, and we're going to import that. It does take time, and if you're not connected to the internet, it's not going to work, but that's okay. Right. So here's our page. So if I go fit to height, you can see that we have the same page that we started with. And if we fit to width, so we can see what we're doing. And you can see the various different informations and bits and pieces about Jules Verne and his career, which is pretty cool. One of the things I want to point out is down here at the bottom of our screen, we happen to have an active URL link, which if I click that will take us right back to the page where we originally got our information from. Very handy, especially if information changes. Okay, one of the things that's very important to understand is that not all URL pages, not all web pages, will import into a Scrivener project. Wikipedia pages are notorious for not importing correctly. They have to be treated slightly differently. So what we do is we're going to select the URL, copy that across. We are going to go back to our research folder, add from web page, paste the URL in, and then I'm going to import it as a web page complete. That's the bottom option on this file. It does take time, and eventually it will do what we want it to do. It's just thinking. Still thinking. There we go. Right, so what we've got is we've got a URL that's right in the middle, an active URL. Now this particular one will bring up my Internet Explorer, and for those of you who are familiar with the Windows systems, you'll understand I don't like Internet Explorer. This one down here will bring up my standard browser window, so I will click that one. And we go right back to the URL page that we originally got the information from. Nice, simple, and all the URL pages that we want, we have bookmarks right in our project. But what if we have other things? What about if we're drawing inspiration from images? What do we do with those? Well, we're going to come back to our research folder, and we are going to add from a file. And we're going to add an image. Now I downloaded some images before. All of these images I have checked. They are in the public domain license, so therefore they're free and okay for me to use in these demonstrations. So I'm just going to select this one here as the cave. And isn't that an inspirational image to look at? So how am I going to look at this while I'm writing my stories? Well, what you're going to do is you're going to split your screen. That's this one over here. And I'm going to split it horizontally so I can see what we want. And I'm going to take this particular one here because it's a smaller version, and I'm going to lock it in place. And that was a left-hand click on that little drop-down button, lock it in place. So it's changed the color, so I know that it can't change if I decide to select something else by accident. Then I'm going to come back to this other window, make sure, just click on it, make sure it's active, and I'm going to select my chapter and put it into a mode that I can actually write in. And so now I can write my story. About the cave. Okay, characters. How does this work for characters? Because we can do exactly the same feature within characters and of course settings. Well, if you created your project from the standard template for novels, you will have embedded in the system a template for character sketches. I'm going to right-hand click and I'm going to add new from template, a character sketch. And I'm going to call this one Johnny, just because I can. Now I can add an image to this Johnny file. If I click on this button over here, this is our inspector, you'll see that we have this space that says drag an image file. Well, if I go and open up the folder, we have, I like this picture, why not? I'm going to drag that one in and we're going to call that our Johnny character. So how do I see Johnny while I'm writing? So what we're going to do is we're going to unlock the cave image and we're going to turn that one into Johnny. And so there's our Johnny information. Now, I'm not a big fan of the Scrivener template because that's why. It's hard to see what you want. So if you're going to use Scrivener for your character sketches, you may want to change this template so you can actually see what you're doing on a regular basis. But regardless, we'll leave it at this. And I'm going to lock this one in place. Now I'm also going to lock in place the inspector. So that way this image doesn't disappear when I go and change this window over to my manuscript. So that's this button here, lock the inspector. Then I'm going to select on this one. And now I can type about Johnny. Every single file that is embedded within Scrivener that is of this text format on your inspector window up here in the synopsis, you can change between text information or an image. So if you happen to have an inspirational image that you want to use at any point in time, feel free to throw it in there. But feel free to also throw other images as well. You don't need to have that image restricted to just one file. Remember, you can also import other things into a Scrivener project, such as document files, and of course your text files. So anything and everything that you might be using as your research notes or inspirational images, feel free to throw it in. It's one of the things I love about Scrivener. It's all in one spot. Here's hoping you found this video useful, and I look forward to seeing you next time.